Welcome back to Studio 10. Well, he is a Disney director who wowed a legion of young fans with his work on Happy Feet 2. But Gary Eck's latest work hasn't gone down so well with his audience. In fact, it's been banned from Australian TV and in cinemas. Let's find out what all the controversy is about. Please welcome Gary Eck to Studio 10.
Hi, Gary.
Yes.
Hello. God, Gary, it's going to corrupt our minds.
No. Turn the TVs off.
No, leave them on.
Can I say I love this ad so much? When I first watched it, I literally clapped at my laptop.
Oh, well, there you go. Really?
So I'm sure we'll go into the details, but it's such a smart...
Did it do anything back?
No, but it appreciated that I clapped for it. It bowed. But
what a great... Talk us through it. Talk us through what the ad's about.
Well, look, basically, you know, I think it's pretty innocent. It's, you know...
Oh, it's a bit saucy.
Oh, come on, Jessica. No,
I loved it.
Yeah.
I suppose we need to tell people what it is.
Well, look, basically, it's, you know, this young couple go into a pharmacy to buy a condom and they don't know their size. So the assistant comes up and says, look, you know, can I help you? And he goes, look, you know, I don't, we've been overseas.
I've been to Europe.
You know, I don't know a European size. And, well, she, you know, just quite openly says, look, why don't we just try one on? Like they're just trying on a pair of shoes. And that was the whole idea, just to kind of normalise the idea of buying condoms and don't make a big deal of it. So we sort of cut to them now in sort of various positions trying on the various...
But you don't see them so
you don't
much,
see
do you?
No, it's completely obscured.
It's like
I was outraged because I had to sign in to YouTube to prove I was over 18.
And then I got
to the ad... And you couldn't see anything. Not even the food.
Let the poor man tell the rest of the story.
Oh, no, look, I mean, that's the whole...
You can't show it in Australia. That's the beef, isn't it?
We can't show it on Australian TV or cinema advertising, which is kind of insane because the ad is restricted to MA films only. Mm. But we had two written complaints. Someone took their family to see the movie Carrie.
And found plus.
I know, that's the insane. And found our ad in, you know, offensive and actually went home and actually watched the ad because they give the YouTube link as well. So they've obviously watched it and they gave great details as to
what was happening.
And there's
like litres and litres of fake blood and horror in Carrie, but you can't watch like someone's feet doing something.
That's right, you know, we're pushing the safe sex message and, you know, someone takes their family to see Carrie and suddenly we're irresponsible.
I saw on YouTube this morning that it has had more than 5 million views so far.
In fact, it's had over 10 million because people are reposting it. So it's getting millions of hits on other people's sites.
And what's the reaction around the world been?
I mean, it's been epic. Like, Huffington Post ran it and they've had hundreds of comments and people writing, oh, this should be a Super Bowl ad, you know, this is funny, why isn't this on TV? And
but isn't that the perfect result, though? Like, you get it banned, you get the controversy, everyone goes, well. So if it hadn't have been banned, you'd be even more trouble.
That's right. I mean, the funniest thing I love is that German primetime news played the ad.
Well, the Germans will play it.
I know, they'll play story. It's
this
entertainment
is,
there.
This is not very hardcore.
Yeah, that's right.
They're only cool people.
It's actually
part of... This is a double standard, isn't it? This is a small minority inflicting their views on the majority. Because back in the 80s, when I chaired the National Advisory Committee on AIDS, and we were trying to get condoms that promote the use of condoms to prevent the spread of the HIV virus, we wanted to put a photo of a bloke called Condo Man, who looked very much like the Phantom. Yeah. but he was never caught short because the Condo Man never went out anywhere without a condom in his pocket. And it was a really good poster. But do you think we could get it into cinemas? No, we couldn't. Yeah. We couldn't get that into any cinema in Australia. They just had another view. And you think, well, hello, this is the movies.
Yeah.
You know, where people are showing and having sex. And you know, what is wrong with a condom?
Can I say on that note, Ida, that I love the way you pronounce cinema.
Awful to think that you had so much difficulty then and now we're having
the same. So all these years later we're still having the same argument and yet the spread HIV is on the increase in Australia. Not in huge numbers, but it is on the increase and we do need to remind people about safe sex practices.
The music videos these days and they're so raunchy.
Oh my gosh. I've seen Rihanna's like lower parts gyrating in ways that I think are absolutely X-rated.
Yeah, and this is clearly tongue-in-cheek.
Well, I mean the crazy thing is, like even on TV, you can watch you know, at 8:30, a very violent show where, you know, people get their heads blown off and it's very graphic, it's very real, it's, you know, very confronting, yet, you know, you suddenly cut to an innocent kind of condom commercial trying to sell condoms and everyone, you know, the uproar and everyone's, you know, you can't do it.
And I think the nice thing about how you're showing this young couple, who are sort of a young, sort of healthy-looking couple going and having a discussion about it, is that they're not feeling embarrassed about it. They're actually, they're not walking in, sort of skulking in and being embarrassed. They're like, of course we're going to ask this question and what do you recommend? And I think it's a lovely way to destigmatise something that shouldn't be an embarrassing process.
And, you know, it's a collaborative effort too. The girl and the guy both work to find the right size condom, you know.
And one of them rings their mother too. That's my favourite. Have a chat.
That's my favourite line. You see them, they're both going for it. And
Spoiler alert.
Yeah.
One of them rings their mother.
No, the mum, she's on the phone and... She's on the phone and the mum says, you know, she says, look, hi, mum, I'm just trying on some condoms with Tyson. And that's his real name. Look, this woman over there is just going, oh, my God.
Now, obviously we
but
can't
secretly
show...
writing down the number to... everyone's going to go
it's
home and YouTube.
It's a great ad with a really important message, so well done, Gary.
That's the clear thing.
Gary, thank you for joining us. Obviously, we couldn't show the ad in full because...
I know.
..the ban, but you can see it on YouTube. It's certainly worth a look. Thank you for joining us.
Yes.
5 million people,
all right,
can't be wrong.
You are watching an all-new episode of Studio 10. It continues right after the break. Here's Jono with a sneak peek of...